performance rendered by our students was not only mellifluous and soothing for the ears, but also pleasing for the eyes. It was breathtaking indeed.
I now request our principal, Mrs. Mithali Rudra, to address the gathering.
A very good evening and warm welcome. Esteemed guests, I'm sure you've been waiting for this evening as much as we have been. This presentation of 2 to 2.5 hours actually requires, and I'm sure you know that, a lot of hard work and preparation because we are all amateurs working on it. Starting from brainstorming on the concept to deciding the characters in which we have proper auditions, writing the script, choosing students for the dance and the choir, training the students, giving them time for proper rehearsal. Remember, we're dealing with almost 1,500 children from class 1 to 9. And we try to see that each one participates. And of course, the children's efforts. And I'm really proud to say that today you will see 71 characters on stage, 9 narrators, and 3 compeers. The rest of the children are there in the choir and the dance. Why does a school invest so much time, energy on this? It is not only to showcase the talent that a child has, but it also helps them develop their skills. It helps them to first discover, nurture, and then develop their skills. Each one may be differently gifted. Some may be very good at dancing, another good at singing. Someone has very good communication skills. There are so many of them. Sometimes we do not even know what we are really good at until an opportunity is given. That is why the various activities we have outside the classroom, whether it's the concert, the sports day, or various other activities like the project, the competitions. This is to build up a complete individual, what we call a holistic development of the child. There goes a story in which a man was carrying a lantern during broad daylight, and when he was asked why he needed a lantern when the sun was so bright, his reply was, "I'm searching for a man." And when he was told there are so many men on the road, he said, "Yes." I'm sorry, please bear up with my throat. He said, "Yes, but what I can see is probably a journalist, a lawyer, a choreographer, a businessman, a politician, a leader, engineers and doctors, of course, but I don't see a man." So the question arises, who is a man? And therefore, we all know, or what we should know, is that a man is a person, is an individual, or the man is he who has love and affection for his fellow men, who's aware of the environment in which he moves about, who is ready to help, lend a helping hand for one who needs it, who has empathy for others, who is an active and contributing citizen and helps to improve the society. As Swami Vivekananda has said, that education is man-making. And that's what we are here for. The school is there for. Yesterday's Times of India, in the speaking tree column, there was Gandhiji's views on education, holistic education. I'll just quote from there. Gandhiji, and I quote, "An education which does not teach us to discriminate between good and bad, assimilate the one and eschew the other is a misnomer." Further, he said, "Education is human transformation and not acquiring information only." So when the child comes to school, he doesn't come to just gain information or knowledge. He can gain that from textbooks and other sources. I'm really sorry for my throat. But when he mixes with the others and that chance he gets in various activities, that's when he learns the skills of life, which are very important. And that is why we have these various presentations. I'm sure the children have learned a lot when they have worked together. They have learned to work together, collaborative work, learn to give space to each other, learn that someone can be a little better than me. It doesn't matter, I can try to make it better. That's what this entire presentation is about. Of course, we've tried to add as much essence into it as possible. I will end here because my throat is not supporting me. I'm sure you're going to enjoy the evening. So have a happy viewing. Thank you.
Jessica.
Thank you, ma'am.
Before we move on with our event, let's
invite Mrs. Jennifer Mistry for some important instructions.
Thank you, Jessica and Adya. A very good evening to one and all. Dear parents, you are requested to please be seated in your respective seats. Do not change the position of the seat and move around. Kindly put your cell phones on silent mode. Photography and videography is strictly prohibited. I repeat, photography and videography is strictly prohibited. Kindly do not bring eatables in the seating area, and you are requested to follow the instructions given by our crew members. You will be informed about dispersal of respective classes after the finale. Hence, you are requested to remain seated till then. Audience, your cooperation is solicited for the smooth functioning of today's program. There is a car parked outside, number MH03BH9600, near Mangal Dairy. You are requested to remove it immediately. Thank you and enjoy the program. Over to you, Adya and Jessica.
Thank you, ma'am. Hey, Jessica.
Yes, Adya. What is it? Why have you gone silent?
I feel lost, despondent, and...
Girlie, Today is not the day to feel blue. Today is the day to hop, skip, and jump. Yes, today we are having our greatest show. A little birdie told me that this year, our school is putting up five...
Hey, do you hear that?
What? Yes.
It's so soulful, isn't it? Look, that's a motley fool.
A motley fool. A fool. That's the last person we need for our annual concert.
Jessica, don't get fooled by his appearance or by what he's called.
Adya, this really isn't the time to meet a fool.
They are funny, wise, intelligent, well-read, and some can even perform gigs.
If we stand here anymore, that motley will turn us into pumpkins.
I wonder why those children are following him.
He seems more like the Pied Piper of Hamelin than a motley fool.
Children, stop following me.
You are so colorful.
What are you doing here?
Stop playtime.
Aha. Now that very important. Go. Go and play.
We were going to. Where you distracted us? You are so weird.
What? Aren't you all playing? Running around? Play hopscotch. Play tag. Hide and seek. Parents? Is this how your children play? Do you give gadgets to play with? Hey kids, come on! Watch me jump! Watch me dance! Watch me play!
Yes, yes!
Parents, a piece of advice. Don't give your children gadgets to play with.
It looks good.
But this age.
Like in one of your Instagram.
And by the way, are you all fidgeting with the phones? Have you switched off the phones? Because you see, I might get addicted. Oops. I mean, distracted. I think I will have to use my magical powers.
My phone's not working.
What do we do now? I don't want to go home so soon.
Children, I'm here.
What's in your rucksack?
See for yourself.
Which books are these?
Whose pictures are these?
Are you a storyteller?
I can be one.
Please tell us a story.
Oh no, I don't like stories. They're boring.
Okay, so children, today I will tell you short stories from master writers.
Short stories?
Yes, short stories from great literary giants of Indian literature. Come on, pick a picture.
Here it is. Motley.
He is from the famous RK lineage, a famed writer for all age. The creator of Swami, the funny tiger, and fictional Malgudi for every reader. Clever, realistic, like the Banyan. He is none other than RK Narayan.
RK Narayan!
Presenting a tiger in town.
Once upon a time, in a small place called Malgudi, there lived a group of friends. Swami, Mani, Rajam, Vasu and Subhu. They went to SM school, which was close by. Their headmaster was very strict. Life was simple and uncomplicated until one day when a tiger entered their school. There was pandemonium and confusion everywhere. Come, let's go and witness the scene there.
Let me see.
revolution all about? I'm tired of running. I need rest. I need to find a place to sleep for a while.
What is going on here?
Teacher, there's a tiger in the headmaster's cabin.
So what? This school is already a zoo with animals like you.
No.
Oh, Kalyani, I was looking for you only.
Sari, you know what? A tiger has entered the headmaster's cabin.
Really?
Yes. And it is scaring the daylight out of him.
Is this how you behave with the teachers? Go back to the class right now.
Hey, Vasu, did you surely see the tiger?
How big is it?
It is very big. It is as big as the door.
As big as the door? Are you sure?
It's a tiger and not an elephant.
Wait and see. He is going to come and eat us all. Oh God! He must have done something to the headmaster.
Oh, then we won't have any classes.
And we will have a holiday.
Yay!
Hello.
Take it back to the place where we know that all we have could be anything we wanna be. We can tell by the noise that the boys are back again. Together making history. It's time to show how
to be a superhero.
Just like a showdown.
The superhero.
With the best, no doubt.
Like we used to do.
This is my
time, and I'm telling you all,
the boys are back, the boys are back,
the boys are back, gonna do it again, gonna win up the neighborhood, the boys are back, the boys are back, and not the boys are back, the boys are back, the boys are back, that's the only thing. The boys
come out of the white when the fire every single time. Undefeated, you're in our house, yeah. We can rock, we can shock, and it's gonna be live. And tonight we're going all out. It's time to go out.
We are superheroes.
Just like a showdown.
Pedal to the metal
ball. We're the best, no doubt.
We move it like we used to.
This is our job.
And I'm telling you all,
the boys are back.
The boys are back.
The boys are back.
Let's do it again.
Gonna wake up the neighborhood.
The boys are back.
The boys are back.
Coming up the ball. This time you want
to know what they've got. The boys are back.
Yes. The world to solve the mystery, fight the battle, save the world. No one can stop us now. We're the ones that make the move.
Check whether the door is locked.
Yes, teacher, it's locked.
Now go back to your class. Well, now that the door is really locked, we should think of a way to get rid of this ferocious beast.
Madam, madam, don't call it a beast. Tigers have feelings too. By calling it a beast, you're hurting its feelings.
Hello, who are you? You better stay out of this. You don't belong to this school, huh?
Madam, whatever. You stay out of this, huh?
Kalyani ma, at this moment what we need is a person with a gun.
Rukmani teacher, can you please go and call the police? The police will surely have a gun.
Yes, I will go call the police. But till then, does anyone have a gun?
Huh? Gun na?
Yes, I have gun.
Basu, what is this?
Gun.
Basu, don't bring toys to school. Let us get over this situation. Back to your class.
What happened? The police will take a long time to arrive. What do we do? Let's call Shikari Shambhu.
Who? Who is Shikari Shambhu?
Shikari Shambhu.
Oh, that Shikari Shambhu. The one with the double barrel gun.
He is a wanted poacher and his license has been revoked.
But who knows? His gun can shoot bullets too. You don't believe these poachers, do you?
Listen to these humans. They are hilarious. They just talk and talk and talk. They cannot take any decisions. I pity them. I mean no harm. And it is not my fault that I am 11 feet from tip to tail. These silly humans are disturbing my sleep. Sweet dreams. Sweet dreams.
Look for the bare necessities, the simple bare necessities. Forget about your worries and your strife. I mean the bare necessities of Mother Nature's recipes that bring the bare necessities of life. Wherever I wander, wherever I roam, I could be fonder of my big home. The deers are running in the jungle to be beat up for me. When you look under the rocks and things and chickens at the fancy pigs and maybe try a few. The bare necessities of life will come to you, will come to you. Look for the bare necessities, the simple bare necessities. Forget about your worries and your strife. I mean the bare necessities of what are your ten recipes. They're just the bare necessities of life.
Or a prickly pear, and you pick a raw pawpaw, wrong next time, beware. Don't pick the prickly pear by the paw. When you pick a pear, try to use the claw. But you don't need to use the claw when you pick a pear of the pink pawpaw. Have I given you a clue?
Shambhu quickly. No
waste time. But does anybody know where Shikari Shambhu lives?
Yes, teacher, I know the place.
Go and get him.
Move aside. Shambhu, the great Shikari is coming. Our savior has arrived.
Who? Shambhu Shikari? Let's see.
Hold it!
Where is the tiger?
He's in that room. Go and shoot him. Ha! That's a brilliant idea.
The headmaster and the tiger are in the same room. Interesting. Very interesting. Get ready, everyone. We all know what will come out of that. Headmaster? Hellappa, headmaster! Headmaster, I have come. I will save you.
Who invited this joker here? I hope he doesn't make matters worse. By the way, who even is he?
Shikari Shambhu.
He?
He Shikari Shambhu?
Yes.
She?
One of you go inside.
He's a very good Shikari.
Okay. I'm fine. Now, somebody get me a ladder. Who's the in charge in here?
We are not the in charge.
Be quiet. Are you the in charge?
I am not the in charge.
Then you.
No. I am not the in charge. The headmaster is in charge.
In my understanding, the headmaster is presently not in a position to give orders.
What do we do now?
Oh no! I cannot see the headmaster anywhere. And that tiger has put on weight.
Sir, you are right, Swami. Even I cannot see the headmaster anywhere.
Oh, what a tragedy. Who would have thought the headmaster would have come to such an end?
Oi! Mean no harm. I was just feeling lonely, so I thought I will make friends with the headmaster.
That tiger says, I mean no harm. Get me a stool. I'm an expert at shooting tigers. Let me shoot the tiger.
Open the door. I will go inside there. No need to shoot the tiger. That is my tiger who has escaped from the circus.
Are you sure? You're going into the same room as the tiger, then he will become fatter.
Now that I know what humans are made of, I'm not afraid of them. I will go back to the jungle, my home. Vicks can no longer control me. You tell me, who is superior? Yes, you know the answer. They called me a beast. How dare they? Well, aren't they civilized beasts? I hear something. My master is approaching me. I'm going to fall like a rat.
Ha! There you are! How dare you escape from my circus? How did you even think that I would spare you?
You tricked me into working in a circus! You ill-treated me! And I forgot what freedom is!
What? You wanted freedom from me? Ha ha ha! You would always be under my control!
No! I deserve my freedom! I don't want to be a slave anymore. I'm a brave creature of the forest. I shall have my freedom. I will not give in. I shall not succumb.
Forgot.
that you push me past the breaking point. I stood for nothing, so I fell for everything. You held me down, but I got up. When I'm ready, cause all the dust, you hear my voice, you hear that sound. Like I'm gonna shake the ground. You held me down, but I got up. Get ready, cause I'm not enough. I see it all, I see it now. I got the eye of the tiger, fighter, dancing through the fire. Cause I am a champion, and you're gonna hear me roar louder, louder than a lion. Cause I am a champion, and you're gonna hear me roar. Oh, 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 oh. Zero to my own hero. You held me down, but I got up. Get ready, brushing off the dust. You hear my voice, you hear that sound. Like thunder gonna shake the ground. You held me down, but I got up. Get ready, cause I've had enough. I see it all, I see it now. I got the eye of the tiger, the fighter, dancing through the fire.
Mother-in-law Gauramma. Shamanna was her husband. She has two sons, Girish, who is settled in India, and Chandru, who is settled in the USA. Gauramma favors her son, who is settled in USA, as she considers him to be doing better in life as compared to Girish. She is very excited for his return after 6 years.
Not even let me count my dollars. Who's there? What do you want?
There's a telegram for Gauramma from the USA.
Chandru is coming. What a great news. Listen everyone. Chandru is coming. He's returning from America. Amma, tell me what Chandru likes. I will prepare everything for him.
Yes, yes, you will have to. You are the daughter-in-law. It's your duty. You first
Lata dear, please get us a cup of coffee. Amma?
Yes, my sweet daughter. Your NRI brother Chandru is returning after 6 years. I can't wait to see him.
Oh, wow. I shall go and make some space in my cupboard. Chandru brother will be getting a lot of things I have asked from him. Makeup, bags, clothes. Oh, I can't wait.
Yes, yes. And even dollars. He will get you all the things that you have asked for. Your other brother Girish is not able to buy anything for you. And your sister-in-law Viduta, she comes from a pauper family. Listen, listen, Chandru's father. We will have to go to Krishnappa and Parvati for their daughter Jamuna and our NRI son Chandru's wedding. Why are you lingering here? Keep it. Go away.
Gauramma, don't you think a girl like Jamuna, coming from such a wealthy family, will have different lifestyle? Won't it be difficult for her to adjust in our middle class family?
Your thinking is middle class? No, not at all. Even my son is earning in dollars. We are no less now. We are from the rich class. I want to fulfill all my desires that I couldn't fulfill in Girish and Viduta's wedding. You could have sold your house for the wedding. What a pathetic wedding it was. We had to hang our heads in shame. That was so selfish and unkind. That's why people say you should get your brides from wealthy families. I know Jamuna will be the best match.
If you have money, then like a sun you'll shine. And if you don't have money, like a dog you'll whine. This nasty storm of discrimination has started in my life. And I know it is going to spiral into something worse.
Oh, Gauramma, stop this! We have to leave for Krishnappa's farmhouse. They might be waiting for us.
Yes, yes. Please carry all the gifts that we have packed for them. Even they should see. We are not less now. Even they should see our wealth and status.
Shamana and Gauramma visit Krishnappa's farmhouse to discuss about Chandru's wedding. They go there with gifts and presents. They are astonished by their lifestyle and wealth. Gauramma, with all her greed, has accepted Jamuna as her daughter-in-law, whereas Shamana is not happy with the match.
The guests must have arrived.
Namaskaram.
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 Please sit. Jamuna, the guests have arrived. Please serve them tea and snacks. So, how is Chandru doing?
He's fine. He's in the USA.
When will he be returning?
He will be returning very soon.
How pretty she is! A perfect match for my dollar-earning son.
Yes, yes. My would-be sister-in-law looks so pretty.
And Amma, look at all the sari and jewelry.
Don't worry. We'll get all of them. So, tell me, what does Jamuna like?
My daughter Jamuna is good at painting ikebana. She also goes to butter classes.
That's pretty good. Anyways, let's wait for Chandru's return and then we will decide.
The match is not in our hands. But let us at least continue with the god relationship.
Why not? I am sure Chandru will choose Jamuna as his bride. I will make sure he chooses Jamuna as his bride.
And oh, the amount of wealth that she will bring with her!
They exchange gifts and start leaving. Gauramma informs Chandru about Jamuna and has convinced him to marry her. They are now eagerly waiting for Chandru to return, who will decide his wedding date. Everyone is quite excited for the wedding and have already started with the preparations.
Amma.
Chandru.
How are you?
I am so glad to see you.
How is everyone?
Everyone is fine. How's everything at America?
Fine, Dad.
You must be very tired. Sit and relax. Your Viduta Bhavi has prepared a lot of things for you.
Oh, I miss the home cooked food.
So, Chandru, you're getting married, huh? I have seen Jamuna Bhabhi. She looks so beautiful. You are so lucky. And by the way, where are my gifts?
Don't worry. I brought all of them. This bag is full of gifts for you all.
Thank you. Let us not waste more time. The guests would be arriving. We have to get ready for Chandru's wedding.
USA. Surabhi, Gaurima's daughter, also gets married. In the meantime, her younger daughter-in-law gave birth to a girl child. It has been a year to Chandru and Jamuna's wedding. Gaurima is invited to the USA for Jamuna's delivery and she is very excited to leave for the USA.
Amma, how am I looking? This is one of the saris that Jamuna Bhabhi gifted me for my wedding. That's beautiful. By God's grace, you at least have one Bhabhi wealthy enough to gift you such beautiful sarees.
Leave all these. You pack your bag. You have to leave for the USA for Jamuna's delivery. We are going to have a second grandchild.
Yes, Amma, hurry up. Please carry enough for the floor. The climate will be pleasant and cold. Yes, yes. I can't wait to meet my son and Dola Bahu. I know. This is going to be such a wonderful experience.
I think that your mother doesn't like me. Because I come from a poor family. No, my dear, she likes you. Then why is she so indifferent and rude to me? Viduta, don't be sad. I'm there for you always. But I'm happy that your mother got this opportunity to go to Man at the
USA. I am happy for her too.
USA. Though her journey was uncomfortable, she was astonished by the American and modernized culture. Within a few days, Jamuna had delivered her baby and they had invited their friends for the child's naming ceremony.
As soon as the play starts,
Switch off the mic. Let after this.
Okay.
My God. Stop. You see.
Hello. There is an announcement. Call number MH03 BJ1398 and MH01 CH368 has been parked in the wrong lane. Please move it immediately. Once again, MH03 BJ1398 and MH01 CH368 has been parked in the wrong lane. Please move it immediately. Thank you.
Garima reaches the USA. Though her journey was uncomfortable, she was astonished by the American and modernized culture. Within a few days, Jamuna had delivered her baby and they had invited their friends for the child's naming ceremony.
Oh, what a tiring day it was. But we have finally chosen the baby's name.
Jamuna, your baby is so cute.
And I just love the name that you've chosen for her.
Of course, Mansi. Such a beautiful name. A blooming flower. Look how adorable she is. Oh, the baby is crying. Can you see the baby?
grandmother and granddaughter will go for a walk. Oh, she has slept now. I must return home.
Jamuna, I must say, you're so smart. I want to take my PhD to possess your talent on how to handle a mother-in-law and win hearts.
Nothing so surprising. My mother-in-law is so greedy and stupid. My sister-in-law, Surbhi, does not have any brains. It's so easy to manage such a woman. My co-sister-in-law, Viduta, oh, she comes from a poor family and so innocent about the ways of the world.
My Viduta would never speak like that about me.
You know what? I give them what I don't like and they don't suspect anything.
Oh my God, such poor women.
I have even passed down my old saris to Surbhi and she thought that it was brand new.
Well, that's great. But what's the matter, Girija?
I don't understand. Why should we carry things from here? Nowadays, we get everything in Indian markets. You can buy gifts for a cheaper rate and gift it to those relatives. As it is, they are agreed. They won't notice the difference. And they'll be very happy.
You're quite smart.
Get me, baby!
Are you okay, Jamuna?
Are you fine?
My mother-in-law is such a burden. She can't even take care of a child. God knows when she'll go to India.
We'll take a leave now. Bye, Jamuna.
Bye. Meet you soon. Bye.
I had good sleep. Yeah, right. I just hope so.
How blind I was. Why did I behave so stupidly? I have reached this stage because of my greed. NRI, dollars, USA blinded me. I don't want all these things now. I want to go back to India. How kind and respectful my daughter-in-law Viduta was to me. I will never speak about America, its wealth, and dollar bahu. I will go back to India and live there happily with my daughter-in-law Viduta.
Garima has realized her mistake. She now understands how materialistic and unkind her elder daughter-in-law was to her. She longs to go back to India and live there happily with her family. She leaves and awaits to meet her younger daughter-in-law.
I'm going to see my mother-in-law after so many months. I hope Girish reaches the airport on time to pick her up. It must be Amma.
Viduta, my dear, how are you?
I am fine, Amma. But how was your trip?
Viduta, will you please forgive me? I have been rude to you. I have learnt my lesson. I have changed, my dear. America has opened my eyes. Girish, I have been rude to you too. Will you please forgive me?
Amma, please don't be sorry. I'm happy that you're back. Money is not everything.
Family is what matters the most.
I believe that you believe in the spirit of the Lord. I believe that you believe in the spirit of the Lord. I believe that you believe in the spirit of the Lord. I believe that you believe in the spirit of the Lord. I believe that you believe in the spirit of the Lord. I believe that you believe in the spirit of the Lord. I believe that you believe in the spirit of the Lord. I believe that you believe in the spirit of the Lord. I believe that you believe in the spirit of the Lord. I believe that you believe in the spirit of the Lord. I believe that you believe in the spirit of the Lord. I believe that you believe in the spirit of the Lord. I believe that you believe in the spirit of the Lord. I believe that you believe in the spirit of the Lord. I believe that you believe in the spirit of the Lord. I believe that you believe in the spirit of the Lord. I believe that you believe in the spirit of the Lord. I believe that you believe in the spirit of the Lord. I believe that you believe in the spirit of the Lord. I believe that you believe in the spirit of the Lord. I believe that you believe in the spirit of the Lord.
Himalayas is his playground. The famous Uncle Ken, his paunch is round. He gives life to ghosts and plates. Dark humor is one of his fortes. He's called the short stories James Bond. He's none other than Bond. Ruskin Bond.
Ruskin Bond!
Presenting a Prate in the House.
Once on a time, there was a family who lived. Once upon a time, there was a family who lived on the foothills of the Himalayan ranges.
How come this breeze sprung up so suddenly?
And has also died off just as quickly.
Who is laughing? Who is it?
It's been a tiring day. I don't want to walk to my village now. I'll have my dinner here under this tree and relax.
Oh my God, what are you doing? My dear friend, why do you wish to invite trouble for yourself by sitting under this tree?
Why? What's the problem?
Once I was sitting under the tree and I forgot to snap my fingers while yawning, and the ghost got into my mouth without any difficulty. Since then, I have always been suffering from tummy upsets.
Is that the sound of the prate?
No!
Oh my God, I should hurry up too.
No!
No!
I am the prate that used to live on that tree. They cut down my home, my abode. Why? To widen the road. I have lost dwelling. I need a place to live. What do I do now?
Ah! I know Uncle Ken's house. I will shovel everyone.
Somebody help, but anybody help, I need somebody.
nobody's helping anyway. But now these days we don't know. So I know I've kind of changed my mind. I've opened up the door. Help me if you can, I'm feeling down. And I do appreciate you being around. Help me get my feet back on the ground. Won't you please, please help me?
Scared. They are petrified. It is all because of the Preet.
I don't recollect where I left my spectacles. Where are my spectacles? Has anybody seen them? I recollect keeping it on the dressing table. Grandma, what are you searching? Oh, here they are. Kept precariously on the snout of the teddy bear. Jack, how could you do this?
Didn't do it, Grandma. Why will I hide your spectacles?
Jack!
Now what?
Of late, you have become very troublesome. Yesterday, I kept my prized VPs in the jar after shelling them, and you dropped them onto the floor.
No, I didn't do it. I didn't do any of these things. Someone please help me.
Enough. Jack, just stop being a bad child. Go to bed early. It's an order.
I'm not sleepy, Grandma. And I'm not being a bad child.
See, your Uncle Ken is fast asleep. You two get to bed. Right now.
All right.
Second, third, fourth.
ID.
Ken? Ken, are you feeling all right? You look miserable. And why are you not wearing your pajamas?
Oh, who wore my pajamas? But that's the reason I couldn't sleep a wink last night. Jack, did you steal my pajamas?
No, Uncle Ken. I didn't steal your pajamas.
Why will I do that? It did not fit me.
Where were you sleeping last night, young man?
In grandfather's room.
Yes, that's right. You know I'm a light sleeper.
I know what's happening.
What?
It's that ghost of the maple tree who has entered into our house. First, my spectacles. Then those sweet peas. And now, Ken's clothes. What will happen next? I wonder. Oh, God!
And it's open to the room. There's nothing I can see, but I know that it's the truth. Cause now I'm coming. Don't understand it. But there's no one sitting there. There's a ghost turn around, and nobody to be found. And I'm talking and lay open. Well, don't understand it.
Wander for long. There followed a series of disasters.
Ah!
Ah! Oh God, let me have a look at myself.
What's wrong?
Ah!
Minnie, Minnie!
Oh my gosh! What has happened to my face?
What happened?
How did this happen? Is this a ghost? How dare you do this to me? Oh my, stop laughing! You, what good, my beautiful face! I will not spare you. How dare you stop laughing? Why did I even think of coming over here? My life was so much better when I was in Korma.
I again couldn't sleep a wink last night.
Again?
The parrot kept speaking the whole night.
Enough. We can't stay here any longer. We have to move out of this place. Look at them. Ken and Minnie will have a nervous breakdown anytime.
I thought Aunt Minnie broke down long ago.
Out of your cheek. There's no time for jokes.
I agree with leaving the house. I found ink in the soup last night.
Ew!
Everybody's leaving. It's time to party.
Several disasters later, the family began moving to a new house. Two tempo laden with furniture and heavy luggage were sent ahead. Grandma, Grandpa, Aunt Minnie and the boy squeezed themselves into the taxi with some more luggage.
Thank you.
is that squeaky sound? Where have you kept the parrot? Is it up there on the luggage rack?
I sent it up with the earlier luggage, but just check if there is anything left out.
No, there's nothing up. I'm sure I heard someone talking.
Enough! Let's just get out of this place now. Let's go!
What will happen next?
Let's go! Let's go! A new house! It's waiting for us! What fun are we going to have? Troubling all of them! Let's stop! New house!
In a small village of Calcutta, there lived Subal and Sushil. They are unlike their names. They always idle their time, dreaming of a better role or a better life without realizing the value of their present role. Let's see what desires they have and will it be fulfilled?
No, no! Subrodha! Look at that father and son.
Where?
That means Subal and his son Sushil. You know Subrodha? Subal Dada has arthritis. Of late, he has become very weak.
Yes, Mahendrada.
And to add on to his troubles, he has an impotent son.
See? Here they come.
Oh!
Subal Dada is taking his son Sushil to school.
Oh!
Hey, Sushil!
I'm sorry for my son's behavior.
Did you see how Sushil pesters everyone in the neighborhood? His father Subal often only chases him. He gets tired. The boy Sushil can run like a deer.
Garodia, leave him. He doesn't get caught easily. But when the day Sushil is caught, he receives no mercy from his father.
Hey guys, our teacher Mr. Das is absent today. Hooray! Let's dance, celebrate and enjoy. Hi Raman.
Hi, what are you celebrating?
Today our teacher Mr. Das is absent.
Oh great!
I got this feeling inside my bones. It goes electric wavy when I turn it on. All through my city, all through my home. Flying up my ceiling, baby, in my zone. I got that sunshine in my pocket, that it's all in my feet. That hot blood in my body when it drops. Ooh, I can take my eyes and pop it. Rings so phenomenally, walk like the way we rock it. So don't stop. I'm under the lights when everything goes. You're where that I'm at, I'm getting you close. When we move, I'll be warm, but it's
just imagine, just imagine, just imagine. Nothing I can see but you can do next, next, next. Could the dream end up on this next, next, next? All the things I should do but you next, next, next. Ain't nobody like this but you next, next. It's not the villain, just next, next. It's not the villain. Ooh, something magical. It's in the air, it's in my blood, it's rushing on. Don't need no reason, don't need control. I fly so high, no ceiling when I'm in my zone. I got that sunshine in my body, that good soul in my feet, that outlet in my body, running lots. Ooh, I can take my eyes off it. Wakes up phenomenally. I love the way we rock it, it's so tight. I'm just alive when everything goes. Nowhere I'm ever getting you close. When we move, well, you already know. Just imagine, just imagine, just imagine. Nothing I can see but you, but you can ask. Put the flipping up on you, it's the next, the next, the next. All the things I should be doing, but you can ask, ask. Ain't nobody leaving soon to keep dancing. It's not the feeling, just ask, ask. It's not the feeling, just ask, ask. It's not the feeling, just ask, ask. It's not the feeling, keep dancing.
Oh Lord, today Sushil has a geography test. This boy is still sleeping. Sushil, wake up this instant or I'll be cancelling all evening plans. The Durga Puja holidays are beginning from tomorrow, Sushil. Wake up or else all the luxuries will be taken away at once. Sushi, wake up now.
Oh yeah, my Durga Puja holidays are beginning tomorrow. But tonight, I will go to Mr. Bose's house. They have the best fireworks display in Calcutta. I need to think of an idea to make the destination. That's all good.
Sushi!
Oh, father! Oh, I have a stomachache. I will not be able to go to school today.
Stomachache? Oh, is it so?
Yeah.
I know he's pretending. Then don't go to school today.
Yay! No school. My Durga Puja holidays are beginning from today itself.
There will be fireworks at Mr. Bose's house and yummy rasagulla and khichdi. Sweets will be distributed after the Durga Puja. Well, it is so sad that you cannot accompany me for the Durga Puja tonight. The candy that I bought for you, don't touch it.
What?
Let it be in the jar. Now quietly lie down on the bed and I will get some punchin for you.
Father, I love sweets and candies. I hate that punchin. Oh, it's so bitter. Father, I feel better now. I think I will go to school and then we both can go to Mr. Bose's house together for the puja.
No, no, no. You can't go anywhere. You are not well. Take this punchin and lie down on the bed. Now don't waste my time or I will be late